real quick. Y'all mind if I tell you something? What if I told you you can still plan to make 2022 the best year of your life? You still got time. Friend, what if I told you we can start now and still crush this year? It's currently January 8th. I wasn't here for the start of the year. I was actually in Michigan, so I'm back in Oregon and I'm ready to get this new year rolling. But first off, we gotta organize my life. Okay, so before getting into all this planning for 2022, let's do a quick recap on 2021. The very first goal I accomplished was just graduating from the university with my bachelor's in engineering. I was able to walk the stage about 3 weeks ago with my freshman year roommate. We're officially done with the University of Michigan. I was also able to obtain my dream job. I always said to myself, if I worked in the corporate world, I would wanna work at Nike. Look, God just blew me away with that one. Next, I relocated to Oregon. If you know where Oregon is, it's far. It's all the way on the West Coast, 2,000 miles from where I'm from. It was a very, very big move for me, but I'm happy every day that I took that step and was able to make a new life for myself in a whole nother state, 2,000 miles away from where I grew up at. I've been able to come out here and meet new friends. The greatest part about it is that they love Jesus too. They love Jesus too. Ain't God good? Like, God is so good. In terms of YouTube, at the beginning of 2021, I was able to secure my first brand partnerships. It was a pretty big company and I was able to work with them twice. So the fact that I was able to work with a big brand and they paid me what I'm worth, that meant everything plus more to me. And it really opened my eyes as to where YouTube could take me, where content creating could take me. It opened a whole new door for me that I didn't really know was even possible. And I really didn't have too many expectations of my YouTube channel coming into 2021. But the fact that I was able to secure that brand partnership and then be able to even just like consider multiple others, that really put into perspective what all I can do with this platform. So enough about 2021. We gotta get into 2022, okay? First, we gotta clean. We gotta make sure our space around us is giving us nothing but good vibes. Because if you go into the new year or you're in the new year with a dirty space, you can't think, you can't make proper judgment, your performance suffers, your mental health suffers. It's just a domino effect. It's just really ghetto. So we're gonna start with cleaning my space and then I'm gonna clean out my electronics, clean those out externally, internally, and we're just gonna do a complete just wipe out. And we can ride the boogie, share that beat of love. I wanna ride the So here I am just trying to make sure my kitchen is as clean as possible. I'm loading up the dishwasher, wiping off my surfaces, wiping out my sink, cleaning out my garbage disposal, just making sure everything is squeaky clean before I go into the new year. Or since we already in the new year, before I continue into the new year. Y'all know what I mean. For those of y'all asking, ooh, why she wiping down her appliances? Let me find out. You don't wipe off your appliances. If you're watching this video, go wipe off your appliances right now.
Feelings like I'm touching the ceiling. Will you do something to me?
That time of the year is coming to an end, y'all. Christmas time is over and it's time to put away those Christmas decorations. Until next year. Always talk about keep it real. Only till you got your fill. Then you wanna cry ill will. Really thought you know the deal. Oh well, I guess that's what happens. Two fools be falling in love. Mixing some pain and some passion. Nothing is ever real. Trust in me.
orbiting around and then circle back around to you. Coming back around to you. I'm coming back around.
Even on your worst day, love you in the worst way. Circling around for eternity. Going through the motions, you're turning me eternally.
So what I'm doing here is just sifting through any old files, any old pictures, videos that I might have on my laptop that I no longer have any need for. And I'm just deleting them, or if I still need them, I'm putting them all into a folder so that my laptop is a little bit more organized in the new year. Now I'm actually going through and physically taking a Clorox wipe to each of my devices and thoroughly cleaning them, because with COVID and all of that stuff, you don't know where your phone, your laptop, your iPad has been. So you wanna make sure they're not only clean internally, but externally as well.
Okay, so now we got all that cleaning out the way, we're gonna create some goals and daily habits just to kind of set the tone for how we want to attack this year. I am big on digital planning. I don't think that that's a part of me that y'all have seen just yet. And I just got into this new app called Notion, okay? Somebody messed up with showing me what Notion was, because now my life is in that app. Because I do digital planning, I don't really have a use for physical planners or physical notebooks. So I know everybody going out getting their cute little planners and stuff, but we have an app for that.
So now I'm just jotting down my goals for 2022 in my Notion app. I've broken them into sectors, which include spiritual, fitness, health, YouTube, and career and finances. After I jot down each of my goals for those sections, I then move into my daily intentions, which are basically some habits that I'd like to follow through with on a daily basis. Moving on to my digital planner, where I will be inputting all my important dates. Mostly this will be used for breaking my goals down into smaller bite-sized pieces, helping make sure that I follow through with my daily intentions so that I can actually achieve my goals. I also want to add that this is a daily planner that I purchased through the Notability app. It's pretty cool because every tab is hyperlinked and it takes you directly where you need to go. And it works like an actual planner without all of the turning of pages.
Right? Now that we've got some goals down, got a clear vision going, we got to get inspired. We got to create something that's going to inspire us every day to reach those goals. Let's bring in the vision board. Okay, I saw this TikTok not too long ago about somebody creating a vision board on Canva. I've never done it. This is my first time. I'm excited. And then you create the Canva board and you put it as your screensaver on your phone, on your laptop. That's so cool, and it's a good way to remind you of just your goals, whether it be throughout the day, throughout the week, throughout the month, throughout the year, whatever. It's just to kind of keep your goals at the forefront of your mind, just so that there's no room to get sidetracked. You're on point all the time. Let's get into this vision board, man.
Here I am making my 2022 vision board through Canva. I've already gone through Instagram and Pinterest and decided upon which pictures I wanted to add to my vision board. So now all I have to do is pop them right on, crop them a little bit, and alter them to my liking. I I tried to make sure each of these images related back to the actual goals I had written down in Notion, just so I could always have a visual daily reminder of my goals with me.
Here is my vision board. This is currently set as my screensaver on my computer. I'm just gonna explain it really quickly as to what everything on here means. As y'all know, make his voice the loudest. That's just making sure I'm hearing God in every area of my life. Y'all know he should be all up in the mix. So I'm making his voice the loudest this year and forever on. This next picture is God, I have no idea where you're taking me, but I trust you. So this is basically saying, God brought me all the way out here to Oregon. There's no telling where he'll have me next. So I'm just trusting in him for my next steps and for him to be the ultimate planner of my whole entire life. So this is just a reminder to trust in him, whatever happens. Here's like a shoe room because I want to get some more shoes. Not necessarily this many. This just represents more shoes. And then this 50K for a rainy day. That just represents putting some more money away into savings. This right here represents my job, even though it's a latte. I want to get more comfortable in my role. I want to get more comfortable at the company. You know, just really, really learn my way around, learn the ins and outs. Just overall, or do work that I'm proud of. And then this next image is just a reminder to stay in the gym. We got the YouTube symbol here. I'm not going to put like a number on how many subscribers I want, how much money I want. I'm gonna just let God go crazy with that. And then here's a picture of downtown Portland and then the Portland, Oregon sign. This just basically means I want to explore Oregon more, just kind of get more familiar with my new home. This is a picture of a vlog camera. I want to do way more vlogging, way more documenting of my life because I know that that's what y'all like to see here on YouTube. And then here's spoiler, God wins. That's just a reminder to myself that in any battle that I might be fighting, just remember at the end of the day, God will win. This is supposed to be me looking out a plane window, travel. We turning the pressure up this year. And then this is just a picture of a woman. She says, my standards are high, your chance is low. I don't know. I just got this picture when I searched for money aesthetic on Pinterest. This basically just means miss me with the other stuff. I'm about this cash. That is my vision board. I hope you guys like it.
All right, so we've done our deep cleaning, we've done our goal planning, and we've done our vision boarding. I think it's safe to say we're ready. You think so?